The eye is the organ of vision, which is located in the orbit of the skull. We can say eye consists of accessory structures and eyeball. In that, first of all, let's take a look on accessory structures of the eye. Accessory structures and eyeball. Accessory structures of the eye. Let's talk about accessory structures of the eye. Okay. The eyelids. What are the accessory structures here? Eyelids. Eyelashes. We can say eyelids. Eyelids. And eyelashes. So I think so that when I say eyelids, immediately the visualization will come because we are learning about us. So that's why eyelashes, the small hair on the eyelids, we can say eyelashes, lacrimal apparatus. They're all called accessory structures of the eye. Lacrimal apparatus. That lacrimal apparatus, eyelids, eyelashes are going to be accessory, additional structures of the eye, which supporting eye in various manner. And extrinsic eye muscles. Extrinsic eye muscles. All these are said to be accessory structures of the eye. The eyelids and eyelashes and eyebrows, that above on the eyes we'll say eyebrows, are useful for the protection of the eye. Eyelids, eyelashes, and eyebrows. They are for the protection of the eye. What about the lacrimal apparatus? Lacrimal apparatus is a group of structures that produce and drain the lacrimal fluid, or tears. In our language, we can say tears, which contain salt, mucus, and bacterial enzyme called lysozyme, which is going to dissolve the bacterial cell walls with for a protection on that, we can say even that also. So extrinsic eye muscles. There are 6 extrinsic eye muscles are present here. Extraocular eye muscles, even we can say. That 6 eye muscles. And attached to the human eye itself. Namely, superior eye muscles, superior, inferior, recti muscles. We can say superior recti muscle. Rectus. Recti, plural. Inferior rectus muscles. The 6 muscles we are taking. Just to know the names, that's all. And lateral rectus muscles, superior rectus, inferior rectus, lateral rectus, and medial rectus. Medial rectus. Before we go into the eye, we need to know the accessory structures of the eye. Then after, we'll see the structure of eyeball. Next, superior oblique muscles. Superior oblique muscles. Inferior oblique muscle. These are total 6 muscles, 6 types of muscles which are going to consider collectively called as extrinsic eye muscles. Extrinsic eye muscles. Superior recti. Recti, what do you say? Recti, plural. Superior, inferior, lateral, medial, recti muscles, we can say. Superior and inferior oblique muscles. Okay. Superior and inferior oblique muscle. These are the muscles of eyeball. We can, that muscles surround the accessory structures. We consider them as a accessory structures in general. Now, moving on to the eye. Structure of eye, that means structure of eyeball. Let's start the structure of eyeball. So before that, let me say once again that what we are seeing in the accessory structures, the accessory structures include eyelids, eyelashes, including eyebrows also. And then lacrimal apparatus, that lacrimal, hardarian, meibomian, whatever the eye glands are present, we can say lacrimal apparatus. And extrinsic eye muscles. In the extrinsic eye muscles, superior rectus, inferior rectus, lateral rectus, medial rectus, and superior oblique muscle, inferior oblique muscles, we can say. Okay. Then now let's move on to the structure of eyeball. Okay. We can classify that total eyeball into 3. Fibrous tunic, vascular tunic, nervous tunic. Fibrous tunic, number 1. Fibrous tunic. Okay, fibrous tunic. One after another, we have to learn these particular structures. Number 1, fibrous tunic. Number 2, vascular tunic. Vascular tunic. Number 3, nervous tunic. means the total eyeball we can classify under these three. In that some one after another issues will come, and whenever they come, we'll make them into the respective category. Notes making is very important here. I'm making notes for you. So fibrous tunic, vascular tunic, and nervous tunic. Okay, so let's start the structure of eyeball, which include that anatomically the wall of eyeball can be divided into three layers: fibrous tunic, vascular tunic, and nervous tunic. Nervous tunic itself called retina, which is a well-known name for us, and along with that it also has the lens, which is held in position by suspensory ligaments. Let us see one after another. First of all, let me visualize the fibrous tunic for you. Fibrous tunic. What is fibrous tunic? The fibrous tunic is the outer coat of the eyeball, consisting of the anterior cornea and posterior sclera. Posterior sclera. What I am saying, that only I'll show that make us to understand very clearly. So what is the outer coat of the eyeball? That anterior cornea, and posterior sclera. Sclera is little bit thicker. Posterior sclera. Okay, so I'm labeling here because a clear picture is required, or otherwise you can't read the text. So what is this? Cornea. Where it is? Anterior. And what is this? Posterior sclera. Anterior cornea and posterior sclera. Okay, that cornea acts as a fixed lens. The cornea is going to act as fixed lens. Okay, then and the posterior sclera is just for protection, we can say here that the cornea is a non-vascular transparent coat. Talking about and writing there itself, non-vascular transparent coat. We can see it is considered as fixed lens, and also we can say it is a non-vascular. What is non-vascular? No blood capillaries here. Non-vascular transparent coat, which covers the iris, colored iris, means making, protecting the color iris. Iris will come next. Okay, then cornea is covered by a thin layer called conjunctiva. A thin layer of cornea. Here you'll understand when I draw the eyelashes here, that eye and eyelashes likewise. This is the that eyelashes, that means the hair. So that is covered by conjunctiva. Actually, conjunctiva in the lateral view you can't see. So if I draw like this, you can understand. This is the position of the eye, and this is cornea. Okay, what you can see from here, this is cornea. Okay. So this is called conjunctiva. That means surrounding white of the eyeball, we can say conjunctiva. Most problem in text here, that visualization problem. We can't see, we can't visualize when we are running through the theory. So the sclera, the white of the eye, is a coat that covers the entire eyeball. Okay. So cornea is covered by a thin layer of conjunctiva, we say. And the remaining white of the eye, the total white of the eye, we can say here, this is all the white of the eye. That some we can see, and some we can see inside. That means eyeball it is. The ball, whole ball you cannot see. Okay, so the visible white we can say that which is cover the cornea, we can say conjunctiva. And the remaining white of the eye is a coat that covers the entire eyeball. So that's why I'm writing here. The sclera. The sclera is the white of the eye. Sclera is the white of the eye. And which is a coat that covers the entire eyeball, which is a coat which covers the entire eyeball. Which covers, that means the blue line which I made, which covers the entire eyeball. Okay. Then the sclera gives shape to the eyeball. That is another property. The sclera gives shape to the eyeball. Proper shape, which comes by the sclera, which is stronger and thicker, that makes the sclera makes a rigid and protects the inner part. The rigidity of the sclera, it is rigid and protects inner parts of the eye. So listen carefully, that one after another the parts are going to be introduced over inner parts of protects inner parts of eye. Okay. Then let me remove this. Okay, so that's about the sclera. At the junction of the sclera and cornea, a channel is known as scleral venous sign. This is a, oh, wait, I lost it. Wait a minute. At the junction of the sclera and cornea, at the junction of the sclera and cornea means, oh God. Here in this area. Canal of Sclim, we can say it as canal of Sclim. So shall I label here? This is canal of Sclim. Where it is at the junction of, wait. Okay, at the junction of the sclera and cornea, a channel known as scleral venous sinus or canal of Sclim. Just we are seeing the outer part of the eyeball now. The eyeball posteriorly sclera, anteriorly we can say cornea, the eyeball, that outermost layer. What do you say it as? We call it as fibrous tunic. We said there are three portions. One is fibrous tunic, next vascular tunic, then nervous tunic. In case of fibrous tunic, the fibrous tunic include posteriorly sclera, anteriorly cornea. The cornea is considered as fixed lens. It's a non-vascular transparent coat. And sclera is a posterior white of the eyeball, which a coat which covers the entire eyeball, which gives shape to the eyeball, which makes the rigidity of this particular sclera, the thickness, rigidity, protects the inner parts of the eye, which we can say. And the cornea anteriorly covered by a conjunctiva, we can say. Now, moving on to the second portion of the eye, that means vascular tunic. The second one, we are moving now, the vascular tunic. When you see all of them individually, that you will be able to understand clearly. Vascular tunic. Okay. So here already we made some that we'll arrange them first of all. As I said to you, anteriorly cornea and posteriorly sclera. For that I gave red color. Now moving on. The vascular tunic, which is also called uvea. The other name for the vascular tunic is uvea. This is the middle layer of the eyeball. It has three portions: choroid, ciliary body, and iris. Choroid, ciliary body, iris. The choroid is highly vascularized and looks bluish in color, making the choroid then below the sclera it is present. So choroid is highly vascularized and looks bluish in color. Okay, so that when we understand them individually, you can understand all that remaining issues clearly. So this is choroid. Below the sclera, it is present, choroid. Okay, the middle layer of the eyeball, which has three portions, we said, choroid, ciliary body, and iris. Choroid is highly vascularized, looks bluish in color. It is thick in the anterior part to form the ciliary body. So when it is coming here, there it is going to form a ciliary body. Anteriorly, it is thick and form the ciliary body. This is the ciliary body. Okay, so I'm writing this also. Ciliary body. Okay, next. The ciliary body. Ciliary body is pigmented and vascularized part that consists of ciliary process. That consists of some ciliary process are present here. That ciliary processes. The muscle associated with the ciliary body is a circular band of smooth muscle that hold and alter the shape of the lens. Now we need to draw the lens here. So this is the lens. Okay, so that lens I drawn here, then this is called lens. Okay, the muscles associated with the ciliary body is a circular band of smooth muscles that muscles which are present here, the circular band of smooth muscle that lies and hold and alter the shape of the lens for accommodation, we say, that is near or far vision. We'll see in the mechanism. Then the eye changes optical power to focus an object because of this only. Now, iris, the colored portion of the iris, that means, first of all, let me close this, the suspensory ligaments, which arise from here, the processes we can see, holding the eyeball, that holding the lens, and they are making accommodation here, adjustment of the lens to focus the light on retina. When we complete the whole, we'll see later. Then now, I have to introduce iris to you. Iris. I use yellow color for iris. You can't see the whole... Wait. Little... You cannot see this particular eye lens whole from outside. Means this is our vision side. When you see in someone's eyes, you can't see the whole lens because they are covered by iris. Like this yellow portion I'm showing here. That is iris. One after another, the parts are going to be introduced over that iris. Okay, iris is a colored portion of the eyeball. It is suspended between the cornea and lens. So this is cornea, which we already seen, and this is the lens. Between the cornea and lens, address they are giving, this yellow portion, between the cornea and lens, it is located between the cornea and lens and attached to the outer margin of the ciliary process. It is attached to the outer margin of ciliary process of ciliary body. Okay, then the aperture in the center. Iris is not covering everything. You see here, that aperture is there in the center. The aperture in the center of the iris can be called as pupil. Uncovered portion we can see, pupil. That means actually when you see in the surface, that means the front view, you can see like this. This is the iris, okay? So what you can see, that is pupil. What you can see means, which part you can see through the iris? Lens you can see. The portion which you can see the lens, that you can see pupil, okay? Then after this, the principal function of the iris, what is that? Is to regulate the amount of light entering into the vitreous chamber. Now we need to introduce the two chambers here, I'll say later, but between the cornea and lens, there is a chamber we call aqueous chamber, and between the lens and retina yet to come, we can say vitreous chamber. Okay, so that vitreous humor or vitreous chamber, we can say humor means fluid. Then diameter of the pupil is regulated by the muscles of the iris. Whatever the muscles present in the iris, they're going to they pull back this in the direction here. When they pull back, lens is much exposed. Okay, that all we'll discuss in mechanism. That now this session is to introduce all the parts for you. Okay, now that we are seeing the cornea and sclera, which are parts of fibrous tunic. Then after this portion, what do you say? The choroid is that middle layer below the sclera. It is present and it has a swollen portion, ciliary body. From there, iris is raised over, and with the help of suspensory ligaments that holding this particular lens, and the lens are covered by iris here, that uncovered portion, that means which visible part of the lens we can see, the porous, we call it as pupil. All these are the structures of vascular. Vascular means blood capillaries. What I said to you now, choroid is highly vascularized. Okay, now let's go to the nervous tunic. Nervous tunic here. This is the vital portion. This is a very important portion for the visibility. The third portion, we can say nervous tunic. Before that, I'll introduce all of you back again here, which are unique, which are important for us. That as we said now, anteriorly cornea and posteriorly sclera. And below that, we can see that choroid, which is highly vascularized. The swollen portions of the choroid are called as the see that what do you say ciliary body, and arising from the ciliary body are the suspensory ligaments that are holding the lens. This is the lens, and from the ciliary processes that we can see the iris came. Iris is covering that particular lens. Uncovered portion we call pupil, that we are completed, and some two chambers are introduced. I'll say back again: aqueous chamber, vitreous chamber, filled with aqueous humor and vitreous humor. Now what we want? We want the third in the inner coat of the eye. The third and inner coat of the eye we want, that is retina. Retina is consists of a pigmented epithelium. We can say the retina, that it consists of a pigmented epithelium, non-visible portion, and a neural portion. The pigment, I'll show you that non-visible portion and pigmented portion, everything I'll show you. That pigmented epithelium is a sheet of melanin-containing epithelial cell. But first of all, let me draw you the retina, innermost layer, we can say. This is the retina. Okay, so below the choroid, outer sclera, middle choroid, and inner retina. Okay, the nervous portion of the retina has three layers. So first of all, let me show you the retina, and bringing out the retina now, we recognize the retina now, and we'll take it out. Retina itself contains three portions, we said now. The pigmented epithelium, first of all, pigmented epithelium. Because of more number of terminology, the continuation will miss over. That's why I'm making arrangement of all these particular thing in order. The pigmented epithelium is a sheet of melanin containing epithelial cells that lie immediately between the choroid and the neural portion of the retina. Okay, we will write first of all that, we'll find the address after that. Next, the neural portion. Neural portion is of the retina, is below the pigmented epithelium, where we said melanin containing epithelial cell, that is between the choroid and neural portion. That means below the pigmented epithelium we can see retina. The nervous portion of the retina, neural portion of the retina, contain three more layers again. Number one, photoreceptor layer. We'll make order first of all. Let me know that photoreceptor layer. Okay, below the photoreceptor layer, bipolar cells are present. I'll show you everything. Bipolar cells are present, and below that we can see ganglion layer. Ganglion layer. Before we go to their positions, you should understand exactly what is the outermost to outer to inner. That means here we just came here. Outermost we said sclera, so that's why let me talk about the sclera. So I'm writing here the sclera. Below the sclera, who is present? Choroid is present. Sclera belongs to fibrous tunic. Choroid belongs to vascular tunic. Now this is nervous tunic. Let me see this area. I took in microscope this area. So from outside to inside, that what you can see? Sclera, then choroid. Below the choroid, pigmented epithelium. Pigmented epithelium, all these are said to be retina, isn't it? That below the choroid, pigmented epithelium. Then how it was given address? Pigmented epithelium is present between the choroid and neural portion of the retina. And neural portion of the retina contain, in order, photoreceptor layer, bipolar layer, ganglion layer. If you start sequencing from outside to inside, first we'll get sclera, then choroid, then pigmented epithelium, then the photoreceptor layer, then bipolar layer, and ganglion layer. We'll get six ganglion layer. Then you'll find vitreous humor here. That is for your understanding. I'll show the text diagram also to you. So when I start from here. So what are the events here from outside to inside? This is sclera. First, number one, sclera. Below that, choroid is present. Below that, retina is present. And retina immediately contains pigmented layer. Below the retina, pigmented layer, below the pigmented layer, neural layer is present. In the neural layer, what are the cells? First, we can say the bipolar cells are present. Photoreceptor cells. What do you call cone cells and rod cells? cone cells and rod cells are present. Next, after that, a bipolar layer. Then after that, that ganglionated layer. So for them, we need to visualize them first of all. That we need to visualize them. Then after we can say, we can go through the mechanism of vision and the remaining other. But before I go there, let me show you the in this particular retina itself, some other issues I have to show you. This is the area which we can see. Oh God, gone. So this is the area I'll show you with red color, where the neurons are going, nerve fibers are going. In this place, if any light occurs, that now no matter at all. That place we can say optic disc or blind spot. Okay. Then where the cone cells are going to be abundant in this particular area, where the cone cells are abundant, it has some small notch like. Okay, so that what you can say, that is fovea centralis or macula lutea. The center of the posterior region of the retina is called macula lutea or yellow spot, we can say. This is white spot, this is yellow spot. Where in yellow spot, that there is a fovea centralis is present, and this fovea centralis contain only cones, and that is helpful for the sharp vision. The sharp vision, which is useful while walking, reading, driving, likewise. Mostly all parts are introduced over. That what we have to see after these, we need to go for different that visualization. So first of all, this diagram, we are showing exclusively retina. Okay, so that means we need to understand the remaining layers also. For example, what is the outermost layer? We say sclera. Okay, below the sclera, the bluish layer, what do you call? Choroid. There is a sclera and then choroid. So outermost, sclera, then choroid. Then after we'll understand the remaining. This is sclera, okay, and this is choroid. Below that, we said retina is present in the posterior side. So retina is having the pigmented epithelium back of the eye. We can say that this is the area, the pigmented epithelium. Okay. Next, after that, a photoreceptor layer is present. This is the photoreceptor layer. Here you can see the two types of cells, cone cells and rod cells are present in the photoreceptor layer. Then after a bipolar neuron, you can see here a neuron is a having two poles, bipolar neuron and a ganglion layer. Ganglion means aggregation of cell bodies. A ganglion layer, the aggregation of cell bodies, we can see here. Okay, so this is the retina. Below that, you can write, below that, what you can see, below that, we can see the vitreous humor. Means when we see the eyeball full, total, that in this view, outside is the sclera. Below the sclera, what is present? Choroid. Then below that, retina is present. That area you are now observing in microscope. That means whole retina in microscope. Retina contain a pigmented epithelium back of the eye and photoreceptor layer, that bipolar layer, cell layer and ganglion cell layer. Because to understand the vision, the anatomy of this particular area is going to be very important for us. We should understand all these particular issues clearly. We need to understand all these issues clearly. Okay, so let's talk about once here. Let's talk about all these issues once. This is here. Now let's go to the eye. So what we are seeing till the time? This is a box, but we can't rotate it. Okay, let's come from the beginning. Then we said about the eye muscles, superior recti, inferior recti, lateral recti, medial rectus muscles, superior oblique and inferior oblique. Their function is not necessary for us. Just know that there are eye muscles. Okay. And layers of eyeball. We said there are three layers, fibrous tunic, vascular tunic and nervous tunic. Okay. Fibrous tunic, vascular tunic and nervous tunic. Talking about the fibrous tunic, a superficial layer of the eye, we can say that fibrous tunic, it contains a sclera, that posteriorly sclera, anteriorly cornea, which we can see. Okay. Then vascular tunic. That vascular tunic include a choroid. We can say the posterior portion of the vascular tunic lines most of the internal surface of the sclera. Okay, below the sclera, this is a vascular layer, very important. Okay, next, the ciliary body. Anterior portion of the vascular tunic, the choroid becomes the ciliary body. Okay, remaining is not required here. Wherever not required, I'm not going ora, serra, all these things. Next, from there, the pigmented circle of the sclera of the eyeball, what do you call? Iris. Iris, we can say. Then next, retina. Retina contain pigmented epithelium, neural layer of retina, and photoreceptor layer, we can see. Here, cone cells and rod cells are present as a photoreceptor layer. Then two spots we are seeing. Macula lutea is a minute yellowish area containing the fovea centralis located near the center of the retina of the eye, which is also called yellow spot. Central fovea is a small depression in the center of macula lutea. Okay, besides this, we'll find the both blind spot and yellow spot. Actually, there is some difference here. A region at the back of the eye where optic nerve exists, which I show now. Yellow spot is a sharp vision area, center of the posterior portion of the retina where the cone cells are much more, which we can see. We will discuss more about the eyeball with the different the diagrams, different visuals. We'll discuss about this particular area. Let's take a brief of eye, whatever we learned till the time. The two eyes are located in the sockets of the skull called orbits. The adult human eyeball is nearly a spherical structure. Okay. Then eyeball has three layers, sclera, choroid, and retina. Sclera, choroid, and retina. Okay. So, this is a diagram which we made till the time. First of all, let us take one after another. First of all, let's see the sclera. What we said about the sclera, the external layer formed by a dense connective tissue, we can say sclera. Anteriorly, it become a transparent portion, we call it as cornea. Okay, so white of the eyeball, this is sclera, that is continuous actually, full eyeball, a little bit we can visual, we can see there. Okay, then this is the cornea. Then below that, choroid, middle layer. We said it as vascular tunic, bluish middle layer. Contain many blood vessels, which are thin over posterior two-thirds of the eyeball, but is thick in the anterior part to form a ciliary body. This is a ciliary body. Okay. Ciliary body continues forward to form a pigmented opaque structure called as iris, a visible colored portion of the eye. You can see from surface view, front view, you can see like this, that iris, colored portion. Then it has a central opening called pupil. I think we are visualizing pupil. That means where iris is not covering the lens, that is called pupil. Eyeball contain a transparent crystalline lens which held in place by ligaments attached to the ciliary body. Next, retina. Retina has contained three layers of cells from inner to the outer. Ganglion, inner to the outer. Means here, this is the vitreous humor. That inside the eye, that ganglion cell layer, bipolar cell layer, photoreceptor cell layer. Then a retinal pigmented epithelium can be expected over. In that, there are two types of cells, cone cells and rod cells. Need to discuss about the cone cells and rod cells. That cone cells, you see on the screen, the cone cells. These are photopic cells, we can say. They are active during light present, when the daylight is there. And there are three types of cone cell, red, green, blue. Their activation only makes us to see different kinds of colors. The sensations of the different colors are produced by the combination of these cones and their photopigment. Actually, we have only three types of cone cells, red, green, blue. Their combination makes our different colors visibility is possible. Rod cells, what are rod cells? They're the dim vision, we can say. When light is very less, the rod cells are able to see. When cones are stimulated equally, all cones are stimulated equally, we can see the white. See the rod cells here? twilights, scotopic vision, we can say dim vision. They contain a purplish red protein called rhodopsin, visible purple. It contains a derivative of vitamin A, rod cell, rhodopsin, vitamin A required over. Those people, vitamin A deficiency, rod cell won't work. That means they can't see in the dim light. That, what do you say? Night blindness, nyctalopia, we can see. So just slightly above the posterior pole of the eyeball, there is a region where optic nerves leave the eye and the retinal blood vessel. This is the area which we can say that area as a blind spot where light even fall down there, nothing we can't see. That's why we can say that area where optic nerves are going and blood vessels are going, that area we can say blind spot. Then there is an yellow spot again. What is yellow spot? On the retina, where cone cells are much located, that area we can say. Lateral to the blind spot, there is a yellowish pigmented spot called macula lutea, yellow spot, with a central pit called fovea centralis. In the fovea, that we find more cone cells, which makes a sharp vision. Means when we go for the mechanism of vision, we focus there only, this in the area. From the cornea to the lens, the light will be focused here, then the visual is possible. About chambers we are talking, between the cornea and lens, there is a chamber, aqueous chamber, which filled with aqueous humor. And between the lens and retina, vitreous chamber is present, which contain vitreous humor, a transparent gel. And the mechanism of vision. Mechanism of vision, we have to see in the next class. So we are preparing our ground to know that particular how the visibility, how the vision is possible to see them. We need to have an idea on the total eyeball and their parts. And whatever the parts we end over, we should fix here. That means fibrous tunic, vascular tunic, and nervous tunic. And their order, it is not a nervous system of earthworm. We can say this is the order likewise. Some are side by side are present. So that we have to fix all these particular things in this particular area. And we should know about them. Like sclera, cornea, belongs to the basic portions, which belongs to fibrous tunic or sclera and cornea. Canal of Sclerm is present between the sclera and cornea. Vascular tunic, the major portion is choroid here posteriorly. That only form the ciliary body. And extensions from the ciliary body are ciliary process. And from there, the lens are present. With the lens are hold itself by suspensory ligaments. We can say suspensory ligaments. Suspensory ligaments, we can say. And some muscles are there in the ciliary body. The circular muscles are controlling them. Here only we should write iris. Uncovered portion, iris, where you can see the lens, that you can say pupil. That means all the structure. Nervous tunic, what we said, a photopigmented layer. We can say the pigmented layer, you can see. Pigmented layer. Then our said photoreceptors, cone cells and rod cells, a bipolar neuron layer, and ganglionated layer. Okay, ganglionated layer. Along with that, we have to discuss about the two chambers, aqueous humor and vitreous humor. Aqueous humor is there between the cornea and the lens. And vitreous humor, humor means fluid, chamber means chamber. Aqueous chamber filled with aqueous humor, vitreous chamber filled with vitreous humor. Okay, so this is a complete skeleton of the eye. That means with this, it won't be over. That means you have to take time that I should introduce these particular individual portions and we need to learn about them. Then we'll be able to see the mechanism of vision, how it is happening, accommodation process. And related to the vision, that means what is accommodation, what is myopia, what is nyctalopia, night blindness, how will it come, and the nearsightedness, farsightedness are all the issues, along with the visuals of this particular eyeball, we'll see in the next session, in the next class. Okay, just today class is warming up, we can say, introducing the portions of the eye, like choroid, and posterior sclera, anterior cornea. Like choroid posteriorly, ciliary body, ciliary process, iris, then pupil, aqueous humor, vitreous humor, aqueous chamber with aqueous humor, vitreous chamber, iris, then lens, ciliary body, then that retina, nervous tunic contain the retina and their layers, pigmented epithelium and neural portion containing photoreceptor layer, bipolar cell layer, ganglion cell layer. That means in a short period of time, we learned so many names. So tomorrow we begin from here and show the different kinds of visuals to you to get that strengthen our topic. Then we'll see the vision, mechanism of vision and defects and disorders that also we'll go through. Okay. Then we continue this in next class. Thank you.